guys, today we're gonna talk about, you can see this is the magnetic coil or we can say drain motor. The basic work of this motor is to pull the drain valve automatically. So as you can see, this is the wire thread. So when it pull inside and the drain valve will open. As you can see, these two wire, when we give 220 volt to this motor, and it will start working. It will pull inside this thread, and with the help of this thread, the drain valve is open. So we have these two motor, as you can see. So let me show you first washing machine where it is located. So this is the washing machine. This is top load washing machine, and as you can see downside, this is the drain system of this washing machine. This black one is the drain motor what I show you. We call it magnetic coil also. And as you can see, this is the thread. When this motor worked, it is pull inside this drain valve. When this plastic comes out, all the water drain like this and come here. Okay, so this is the system to drain all the water. So now let's check. I want to test this motor if it is good or not. I want to show you once again. This is the system, how it works. See, this is the thread, it is connected like this, and when we give the supply here 220, and the motor will turn inside of this thread. So, and the drain valve comes out and all the water drain, because the rubber valve what is inside of the drain is up and pull up, that's why all the water drain. So this is the system. So let's check if this motor is working good or not. So let me show you. First of all, directly I will give 220 voltage to this motor directly, then we will see if this motor is working or not. Let me bring extension board. Finally, this is here, and let's check if the motor is working or not. So okay, I'll give you another way. Now you will see, and I have the power now on, and the motor is not working, as you can see. Let's check another one if it is good or not. I'm giving it to 220 volt directly. And as you can see, the thread comes inside, means motor is working. Let me show you once again. See, this is the open condition, and when I give 220, as you can see, slowly motor is working and all the thread going inside slowly. So it means this motor is good and another one is have fault inside. So let's check also by meter. First of all, we have to set our meter on kilo-ohms. MQ, as you can see, this is the one kilo-ohm, mega-ohm. So let me show you with another way. This is nice. Now you can see the value of this motor. Right. Okay, so let's check if it is have some value inside or not. It is under point value 0.450, 460, 70, means under zero, under point the value. And let's check another one so we have idea. Let's check another one, how much values of this motor, because all the motor is same. And as you can see, finally this motor is good, that's why I have 5 kiloohms, 5.88. so this motor is good. It means the other motor have problem inside this one. So we have to check what is the problem inside. Actually I also don't know what is inside, so I want to open and check what is inside, how it functioned. So let's open all the screws. So I speed up the video. Have almost 5 to 6 screws inside, and nice packing. As you can see, the motor and I want to open this one also. Okay, as you can see, this is like this inside, have a small thread. This is the main. Actually we have to open this one also. So one wire is broken. So this is the problem, I think one wire is broken, that's why I think it is not working. I think we have to check by meter if have the same value on both of the terminal. Let's check first by meter, so we will know if this motor is good from inside or not. Let's check. And yes, this, as you can see, this is the value of 5.73 and 75 something. Let me show you once again. Let me set my meter so you can see. Okay, now let me check again. And the value is here, 5.76. it means the motor is good from inside. So what we have to do now, we have to connect this wire and the motor will work. So but what I'm thinking, if I open all the screws already, so I want to check what is inside. So this wire I will connect like this with the, you know, iron. So let's check what is inside first, then I will fix it again back. This is same timer, you know, timer of the washing machines. This also looks like from inside have one motor beside, a big motor, and have too much, almost 7 to 8, you know, like rotators. Very nice fitting. Okay, and the other one is, it was in downside, so let me fix it first, then we will see. Okay. Now, this is the work. You can see both of the side have limitations. It will not rotate 180 degree. So let me fix it again. And after fixing this, let me fix also screws. I will just try it only two screw. So I want to check first one and second one is just opposite side of this. Okay, so now the time is to solder this wire into this motor. So I have iron, as you can see, and I will solder it. Now again I speed up my video, so I will solder it faster. You know, this motor is you can find this motor only mostly in top load washing machines only, mostly, because I see in many models this motor is only in top load washing machines mostly. We have many, almost 7 to 8 model, and all the top models, top load washing machines have same motor to pull the drain. So finally I fixed it, as you can see, in a nice way. It will not break again. So let me fix it back, the cover. Maybe wire is little bit up. Now let's see. Nice. So I think it will work nice, hope, because everything is good from inside, and motor also have value. We see already 5 kilo ohms. Let me fix it back also. This rotator we can't fix anywhere. Have separate clamps type, have separate size also, so we cannot fix anywhere. We have to fix at the same place. So finally our motor is ready. So let's check if it is working or not. I am giving it to back to 20 voltage AC, as you can see, and wow, it is working nice. So the problem only was the wire was broken, as you seen already. Our motor is working fine. See, it is going inside slowly, so it will pull the drain system inside. So this motor is also good. So we have both motor same, and both motor are nice. Let me write on the motor. Okay, so I can use this motor again. And okay, so that's it guys. This is enough for in this video. Hope you understand. That's it. Thanks for watching.